that people are put in the position of being victimized and then having extraordinarily difficult time trying to get their case out. So people like you are and the media, you know, alternative media, becomes almost the last resource for them.
Yeah, I mean, this is the problem. You just hit the nail right on the head. When people go to the police and don't get help, they come to me. A woman is sexually assaulted every 10 seconds in the United States. That's a fact. A woman is sexually abused. It's like every 30 seconds across the United States, okay? And you know what? More than 60% of women don't report it because of the victimizing of the system.
Hey, what's going on? It's your girl, Desiree, from Urban Girl Magazine, and you are watching My Glock TV.
I don't wanna die for them to miss me. Yes, I see the things that they wishing on me. Hope I got some brothers that outlive me. They gon' tell the story, shit was different with me. God's plan, God's plan. I hope that sometimes I won't, yeah. I feel good sometimes I don't, like, yeah. I finesse down Western Road.
Changed for Captain Ricky. It was no longer a black and white world. Somehow he had been transported across time and ages and had found himself in a world which had yet to be conceived. This is a world in which fantastic creatures
roam at night and huddled in caves during the day. It was simply because they lived in a state of continuous pain. These were disembodied spirits who had taken on fantastic forms and wandered through the limbo of afterlife, seeking pleasure where they could find it, usually finding none. Their only joy in dance and music, because it brought a short, temporary relief from the eternal pain from which fate had condemned them. And it was here that Captain Ricky began his fight to liberate the chained minds and souls of those whose entire beings had been so mutilated, for whom the terrors and the torture, the murder and the mayhem had made our world unlivable. Those who had any decency left could no longer inhabit this world. They had to seek relief in vistas of fantasy and things which had yet to come. That was why Captain Ricky was fighting. Because an aristocratic class had emerged, and they'd shaped the world in a way that was beneficial to them. And in some unscrutable fashion, they had left behind their brothers and sisters and condemned them to a world which no longer made sense. It was as if a coven of witches had conspired to cast an unholy spell on the denizens of this earth. And so they wandered the twilight, coming out at night, dancing, fornicating, taking drugs, anything to relieve the boredom and the pain of living in the caves during the daylight hours. The sun burned their skin, and this caused them to howl in madness and terror. And that's why Captain Ricky fights on. We've got to remember that it all started a long time ago. Captain Ricky had suffered from a case of mistaken identity. Locked in one lunatic asylum from the next after his horrible experiences in World War I. He eventually came out and wandered the world as a carny. And it was during this era of the Depression that a time portal opened and whisked him into this netherworld. A world inhabited by ghosts, goblins, and creatures of the night. At night, they would gather around, waiting for that glorious music the only clap Captain Ricky could perform. They begged for it, and if he would not play the music for them, they would grow abusive. And even though I hate to use delicate words, there's no other way to put it, they would defecate on his lawn, pick up the poop and sling it at the house. And if he showed up, they would even pelt him with the foul messes. It's not words I like to use around children, but I don't know how else to convey the absolute horror that engulfed these poor, lost creatures. There was only one thing that could relieve the misery of the world, and was beyond Captain Ricky to achieve it. And yet, he tried. From 1 hour to the next, hobnobbing with one lunatic next hour, and then fending off the advances of
incubuses and succubuses who came to seduce him in his dreams. There was nothing the poor fool could do. And this was the world that Captain McGee inhabited. A sad, lonely world filled with dismal winds, dark lights, and the only light that shone came from within. Deep, deep within. Who were these strange beings and how did they come about? We don't know for sure, but the mists of time surround old tales of how this new world came about. One day lightning had struck and the world had changed forever. And these creatures crawled out of the primordial mud with the Zigbees and the Zygotes, which had been planted inadvertently around the four corners of the world, east, west, north, and south. Normal life disappeared, and only strange, grotesque, sometimes beautiful, sometimes not, sometimes fair, but more often grotesque. And it was often in these vistas that many things would occur. Unnatural acts, which would reduce a normal person to the heebie-jeebies. But this was not to be. Not to be. Brutes. Wielding axes.
You see that girl on over there with the high heels and the red dress on?
You can't have her.
I've heard some stories about her.
I don't want that girl.
Wait a minute. What's that she's doing? She's doing the hoochie coo.
Oh.
That's the one you do with no clothes on. That naked dance.
I'm gonna
give it a try.
I'm gonna try it in the sweet by and by. I don't wanna, I don't wanna cry.
Come here, girl. Let me show you what I can do. That's what we call a time step.